those things, but obedience is essential for the Holy Spirit to fill us. We are here so that the Holy Spirit may fill us, but He cannot come within us if we do not obey the Lord's commands.
Amen. One last comment. From the gents.
Because each time we sing,
when
we nailing Christ again in front of the cross, each time we sing.
Just a comment. Like we can even learn something from the disciples.
Before you do something,
they prayed for 10 days, and there are so many things that they did during those 10 days. They repented. They acknowledged their sins, right? They prayed and they had faith. So you cannot receive the Holy Spirit if you don't have faith. So these are just some of the things we need to do before the Holy Spirit comes. And then the Holy Spirit cannot come when you sin. You have to acknowledge and then repent of your sins. That's when the Holy Spirit will come. And then there is the condition. You have to ask, right? And then if you ask, He will definitely come. So this is the only simple condition. If we ask, He will come.
So by saying that what you say,
amen.
Each and every day, you see how we ask.
I want to thank you Jesus for this wonderful time. Thank you for making it possible for us to come here and worship you. May you be with all the program that we are about to do. Bless each and everyone who is here. May you fill us with your Holy Spirit. May you continue working wonders in our lives. May you fill us with the Holy Spirit. Give us the Spirit also to go out and preach the gospel to non-believers. We believe that when we are filled with the Holy Spirit, it is not us who are speaking to them, it is you, Jesus. Continue because you are with it.
That's you. In Jesus' name,
wonderful class. So try. We can make the
chat.
Because our hearts are no longer the same. And there was a voice from the Father, which means when we repent and God sends the Holy Spirit in us, we are recognized by the Father as part of the family of heaven. Do you get that? So we see the Trinity being involved when somebody is baptized. The Son, the Father, and the Holy Spirit. So when somebody is baptized and confesses their sins and repent, they become in the complete family of this Godhead. So this is the example that Jesus Christ was setting. If you remember, John the Baptist said, "You are the one who is supposed to baptize me, right?" But Jesus refused and said, "Let what has been written come to pass," because He wanted us to see an example of what happens when we are baptized. And since His mission was about to begin, a mission of remission of sin and of witnessing, He was to show us that we cannot do these things without the influence of who? The Holy Spirit, who came in form of a dove. So can somebody open Mark 1 verse 8 and somebody open Acts? Let me have Cassandra. Cassandra, open Acts 1 verse 5.
Yeah. Mark 1 verse 8, "I indeed have baptized you with water, but He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost."
Okay. Yes. sign that.
For John to baptize the water that in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit.
Amen. So we see John baptizing with water, right? As he was baptizing, people were showing that they have confessed their sins and repented. But John says, somebody will come who will baptize you with the what? The Spirit. And who is this one? Jesus Christ. So when we are born of the Spirit, we actually possess the Holy Spirit, right? And our works will be guided by Him, because He is the one who possesses our minds. When somebody drinks alcohol, what does alcohol do to somebody? It possesses their minds, right?
Yeah.
Somebody will begin to act under the influence of alcohol. So when the Holy Spirit becomes a part of us, He owns our minds, and we do according to His influence. So I have this question. What is the relationship between water baptism and the baptism of the Holy Spirit? But before that, can somebody read Justina, Luke chapter 3, verse 21 and 22? Brother here, Acts 19, verse 1 to 4.
And when all the people were baptized, it came to pass that Jesus also, being baptized and praying, the heaven was opened, and the Holy Ghost descended in a bodily shape like a dove upon, and a voice came from heaven which said, "Thou art my beloved Son, in thee I am well pleased."
Acts 19, verse 1. And it came to pass that while Apollos was at Corinth, Paul, having passed through the upper course, came to Ephesus and finding certain disciples, he said unto them, "Have ye received the Holy Ghost since you believed?" And they said unto him, "We have not so much as been, whether there be any Holy Ghost." And he said unto them, "What then were you baptized?" And they said unto John Baptist. Then said Paul, "John did baptize with the baptism of repentance, saying unto the people that they should believe on him which should come after him." That is all.
So the question I asked was, what is the relationship between water baptism and the baptism of the Holy Spirit? So look at this scenario in Acts, where these guys were baptized of the water by John, but didn't know of the Holy Ghost. You get the point? So this actually means that we may not know the Holy Spirit. If we are baptized, because He's the one who gives us that conviction to come to Christ, He definitely lives in us. When you are baptized of the water, it's the same. You are baptized of the Spirit. When you come to repentance, what does that mean? You hear the voice of the Holy Spirit, right? So the Holy Spirit comes in us when we acknowledge our sins and are willing to repent. So even though you may, it's possible that you may not be baptized of the water, but you have repented. Say you have come to believe that Jesus Christ is Lord, you confess, and you repent, then you don't have the chance to be baptized by water. You can still be saved, because the Holy Spirit has had that influence in you. Do we get the point? So, how can a person know for Satan, whether he or she has been baptized by the Holy Spirit? How do you actually know and feel that you have been baptized by the Holy Spirit? It's an open question.
Since we all know the fruit of the Spirit, right? So there are two different things, the fruit of the Spirit and the fruit of the flesh. Is how you can know that you have been baptized by the Spirit is that you start liking the fruit of the Spirit and hating the fruit of the flesh. Like the things that you were doing before, if maybe you were drinking, you were doing all these kinds of things, you find them unpleasing. You find those things that they don't have interest. They are nothing, they are disgusting to your eyes. So meaning the Spirit is working in me is that conscious of knowing that this is wrong, what I'm doing is going to come out of you, having that conscious, that is
super important. Amen. Anybody else? How do you know and feel that you really have been baptized by the Holy Spirit?
Yeah.
Look at this. What the flesh wants is what God hates, right? So when you have been baptized by the Spirit and the Holy Spirit has possessed your mind, everything that you used to like and love, you disconnect yourself from it. Because God doesn't go in line with what you desire. So if you were addicted to alcohol, you were addicted to things of the world, when the Holy Spirit possesses your mind, everything changes. That is why the Bible says, in God, we are new creations, right? So everything that the Holy Spirit likes, we also begin to like. So let's give this one. Being filled with the Holy Spirit. Being filled with the Holy Spirit is Ephesians. Can somebody open Ephesians chapter 5, verse 18? Ephesians chapter 5, verse 18.
Welcome to the Queen's Talk. So today we have a group of some men of God who are really working and doing a great job in teaching and preaching the Word of God to a lot of people. So we are just going to talk to them, just a few questions, and just know how they are doing it and how they are explaining things to others. So, Brother Solomon, welcome to our show. So how is it that, how do you find preaching the Word of God? How do you feel preaching the Word of God to other youths?
Well, I find it joy. I find joy in doing it because it's one of the gifts of the Holy Spirit to witness and to others.
Yeah, thank you very much. Do you have any other challenges that you face in this area of preaching, or maybe do you have something that you can share that you feel like others can have some knowledge about?
Well, the thing to have is to study the Word. When we study, we have more to talk of God. Because when we study the Word, we read the mind of God.
Thank you very much. I would ask for a blessing. I know that you have been teaching the Sabbath school for quite some time now. So how do you find teaching the Sabbath school?
I like teaching because it humbles yourself and you read a lot of books so that you come to understand. Because people are asking different questions, so it really you will grow. Yeah.
Oh, thank you very much. So our lesson this week was about fill us Holy Spirit, and we were praying and we were sacrificing our time just to come and gather with people just to pray for the Holy Spirit to fill us. So Brother Eric, you talk about filling us Holy Spirit, right? Yes. So what are the ways that we can find ourselves to be perfect for the Holy Spirit to fill us? What are the ways that we can stay in and accommodate the Holy Spirit?
Okay, thank you very much. That's a good question. The first thing that we need to understand is the Holy Spirit wouldn't stay in a heart that is not willing to accommodate Him. Yeah. One aspect of being filled with the Holy Spirit is the fact that you need to invite Him. You need to ask of Him. You acknowledge your sinfulness. We look at what happened at Pentecost. The disciples were in one accord, praying and asking for the Holy Spirit. The first thing is, the way of having the Holy Spirit, you need to acknowledge your sins, be a repentant, and ask of Him from God, because He says, seek ye, and you will find. Of course, when you knock, the door will be opened unto you. God is so much willing to give us the Holy Spirit. Only if we ask of Him, He will dwell in us.
Thank you very much. Wow, it was a wonderful time, it was a wonderful lesson, and we have enjoyed and we have taken a lot of scriptures. So we thank you very much for joining our Queen's Talk. See you next time. Thank you. Very much for joining us. So this was the Queen's Talk. My name is Esther, and we were just interviewing some men of God who are doing a lot of work here. They are preaching the Word of God, they are teaching about Jesus Christ, and just doing their passion, and that is showing love to the people. So everybody deserves to be shown love, and everybody deserves to be loved. So this was the Queen's Talk. Thank you very much. See you next time.